How should I keep recovery codes secure? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Recovery codes are an important part of protecting yourself from possible account loss. If your account gets hacked or if you forget a password, recovery codes that you create before you need them are codes that essentially prove you are the rightful owner of the account and generally lead you down the account recovery process to be able to set your new password to something you remember and essentially regain access to your account. Here's the issue. By definition, recovery codes prove you are the account owner. How do you save them safely? You can't just put them anywhere because anybody that has them and knows your account ID could then potentially take over your account. So the trick is to save them in a safe place or in a safe way. Now, to be clear, not all online accounts use recovery codes. However, those that do, I strongly recommend you actually set them up. For example, your Microsoft account, you have the ability to generate a recovery code. It often looks a lot like a product ID, right? One of those long strings of characters that you enter sometimes to validate or activate your product. But the bottom line is, it is something that would, in the future, allow you to prove that you're the rightful owner of that Microsoft account. Other services may do something similar. I've seen tables of numbers where each number acts once and only once. Often it's associated with two-factor authentication. So as part of setting up two-factor, you also create recovery codes to cover the case where you've lost your two-factor authenticator. The bottom line here, though, is that recovery codes, you can generate them. And if you can, you should. And you need to keep them safely. How to do that? There are two basic approaches. The approach that is most often recommended by the online services themselves is that you print the recovery code. Now, that's okay. Don't get me wrong. That's an easy and simple way to save the recovery code. It gives you a piece of paper that you can then store somewhere safely. Maybe it's in a locked drawer, maybe it's in a safe. Don't care. It's up to you. But it has to be someplace both safe so that it's not going to fall into the wrong hands and that you remember where it is if you ever need it. My preference, in fact, is to go digital. By that, what I mean is I will do either of three or four different things to grab a copy of the recovery code in digital form. That could be taking a digital picture of whatever shows up on the screen with my phone or my digital camera. I tend to take screenshots of a lot of things because those are nice ways of keeping exactly what it was telling you, not just the recovery code, but perhaps the descriptive text around the recovery code to potentially help you when the time comes and you need it. The other thing I'll often do, if it's possible, is to literally select the code using my mouse and then copy paste it into a text document that I then save somewhere. Now, in all of these cases, the recovery code is now in a file. It's in digital form. It's either in a picture, or it's in a text file, or it's in something else that makes sense to you, but that is a digital file on your computer. You need to secure that. There are a couple of ways, but they all boil down to using encryption to ensure that that file is accessible only to you. That could mean using zip, a password-protected zip file. I tend to use 7-zip if I'm going to create zip files, but that is a fine, easy, simple way to simply take the file, zip it with a password, and know that it's secure. You could also create a VeraCrypt volume. In other words, literally an encrypted volume for which you could put your text files or your recovery codes for this and any other number of accounts and any other information that you want to keep secure. My approach is actually to use Cryptomator. I use Cryptomator to store these files and a lot of other secure things in a way that is available to me always when my Cryptomator vault is mounted. But the bottom line here is that the neat thing about having things in digital form is that you can back them up. You can be available in multiple places. You're not going to lose your recovery code because you only had one copy of it somewhere that you forgot about. So, bottom line here is, regardless of which approach you take, be it printing it or using some sort of digital and encryption combination, create the recovery codes. Save them somewhere safe in a way that makes sense for you so that if you ever need them, which we hope you never do, but if you ever need them, you'll be able to get them. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/163590. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.